This is the Valley of the Gala Water, also known as Weedale. A quiet and peaceful place. But it's not always been like that. Not many people think of the Gala Water, the river which runs down there into Gala Shields and its tributaries, like this little river here called the Lugget. The Lugget. There's not many people think of them as having a lot of history, but there's loads. There's loads of ruins and castles and towers in this area that are completely forgotten. Just south of Stow here, and across the river there, is what was known as Torson's Castle. Torson's house now. But up this little river, the Lugget, there were another two castles. There's not much legend or history associated with them, but let's go and see if there are any remains. The first of those castles up this Lugget Valley was actually known as Lugget Castle, same name as the burn. And apparently there are very, very scant remains built into these farm buildings over here, but I'm not going to be able to get anywhere near those today, I'm afraid, because they're private dwellings. But the next castle is a bit further up, so let's keep going. Anyway, the next castle I'm looking for is known as Ewes Castle. E-W-E-S, Ewes Castle. See, rabbits and hares can live together in harmony. Should be no divides in the societies. Certainly plenty enough stone in this area to build a castle, that's for sure. I'm pretty sure the castle is just another 200 odd yards up here. And here it is, the site of Ewes Castle. I kind of bet your bottom dollar that the place has just been robbed and robbed and robbed again and again and again for stone over the centuries for agricultural purposes. The dike's over there, for example. See the masonry at the corner of the castle here. All this fallen stuff, look at the size of some of those stones, they're probably foundation ones. Yeah, it's called Ewes Castle, but it's obviously been more of sort of standard Border Reaver 15th, 16th century peel tower design. The barmican wall around the outside, the tower in the middle, maybe a little, looks like maybe a little watchtower or something at that side there, but it's still known as a castle. There are two curlews flying about there, and there's a cuckoo up there because I can hear him as well. You hear the cuckoo on that video? They're easy to hear, but they're not very easy to see. I've never seen a cuckoo in my life. And that was a curlew, which is supposedly becoming very rare, but right in and around the Gala Shields area, they seem to be very common this year, which is great. Now for some people this might be a bit of a long walk to view a pile of rubble. But for me, this is a short walk to an absolutely fascinating and forgotten piece of history, untouched. And also, the wildlife around here is fantastic because it's so remote. So why not come up and have a look at Ewes Castle?
Just imagine the steel bonnets coming and going to this site. A hive of activity, a hive. Probably of fighting and worry and violence.
Where curlews fly and cuckoos cry. Ewes Castle through the centuries lies.